The decline in immune function is one of the key causes of ill health as people age, and it manifests itself as a poor responsiveness to new and emerging pathogens, as a reduced efficacy to vaccination, and also older individuals suffer from an increased frequency and severity from infections they were once immune to. Immune senescent cells are dysfunctional. They show a reduced proliferative capacity to antigen, but they are functional. They retain a very good potent effector function. And we in the ACPAR lab became interested in why these immune cells retain effector function and lose the proliferative capacity. So immune senescence has mainly predominantly been studied in fibroblasts, and some papers exist where they investigate the senescence characteristics in primary human T cells. However, the majority of this work tends to use the marker CD28, or the loss of the co-stimulatory marker CD28, to evaluate senescence. However, this results in a highly heterogeneous population of cells, which encompasses both effector memory cells as well as the senescent cells. So in our paper, we've used the markers CD27 and CD45RA, and we've defined senescent cells as having the absence of CD27 and the re-expression of CD45RA. And these cells are termed EMRA cells, effector memory cells that re-express CD45RA, or just EMRAs. Using these markers, we have found that the mitochondrial content of senescent cells is greatly reduced when compared to other memory subsets. Also, we've used a cationic dye called JC1, and we've also found that the mitochondria in these senescent cells are less functional than the other memory subsets. So we wondered what this does to the metabolism, because the mitochondria are key for the generation of energy. And we wondered whether they were metabolically reprogrammed somehow. So we investigated this using the Seahorse, which is a piece of equipment that measures in real time changes in metabolism. And it gives you a couple of readouts. It gives you one of oxygen consumption, an OCAR reading, and one of pH, an ECAR reading. And we use these two to monitor the metabolism in the cells. And we found that the lower mitochondrial content causes a shift away from oxidative metabolism in these EMRA cells. So they tend to use anaerobic glycolysis to generate their energy. And also we found that they have a far smaller spare respiratory capacity than the other memory subsets. And what this means is there's less energy available to the cell to respond to antigen challenge. Work from our group, from Diletta Dimitri and Alessio Lana, have published previously that the key signaling molecule, P38 MAP kinase, regulates the senescence phenotype. So if you block P38 signaling, you can have a restoration of proliferative capacity as well as telomerase activity in both CD4 cells and CD8 cells. But however, what we don't know is how these senescent T cells generate their energy for this increased capacity and increased function. So we used the small molecule inhibitor BERB-796 to assess the change in metabolism. So when we use BERB-796, we find that we, in these senescent cells, we can remove the dysfunctional large giant mitochondria and have increased, renewed mitochondrial biogenesis. And these new mitochondria are more functional. So then we went on to investigate whether this renewed mitochondrial content would shift the metabolism back to a more oxidative metabolism. However, to our surprise, we found it didn't. These senescent cells still use anaerobic glycolysis for their metabolism. And this increase in anaerobic glycolysis wasn't associated with an increase in glucose. So we were surprised. We wondered how were these cells actually getting their energy. Well, we then found that it was actually through the process of autophagy. So while autophagy is mainly used to degrade and recycle organelles and cellular content, the lysozymal digestion of organelles can be used to generate metabolic precursors for the cell. So along with our collaborators in Oxford, Katja Simon and her group, we investigated autophagy and the role of autophagy in these senescent cells. Now, because we are only ever use human cells, we're constrained about the amount of blood we can isolate. And conventional routes for measuring autophagy tend to use Western blot, and we'd never have enough cells to go down the conventional route. So we use this novel system called the image stream to analyse and assess autophagy. It's a flow cytometric based platform, but you can click on every cell and you have an internal image of the cell. So we assess autophagy by the fluorescence intensity of LC3, a key component of the autophagosome, and a marker of the lysosome, lyso-ID. And then we use this together with a marker for the co-localization. And when we use this image stream system, we find that EMRA cells are impaired in their autophagocytic capacity and ability. However, when we block the P38 signal, we find the autophagy to increase dramatically. So these senescent cells are using autophagy to generate their energy source, and rather than conventional glycolysis or oxidative metabolism. But interestingly, these senescent cells don't use the conventional mTOR signaling pathways, because these senescent cells express very low mTOR in them, which is interesting because mTOR inhibitors have been postulated to retard the effects of aging. So the immune system cells just don't have very much mTOR. But also our findings that these senescent cells regulate their metabolism in non-canonical, non-conventional approaches really offers new therapeutic areas in which to specifically target the T cells to restore immune function.